Hi, and welcome to episode 11 of our Let's Play series. And we are building a slime farm. And yeah, it takes a while to dig out all this rock. But once you find a chunk, it's pretty straightforward to build the farm itself. Just a bunch of these platforms here. And you build it all the way up to Y equals 40, because that's where the slimes tend to stop spawning from that point. So from bedrock all the way up. And just make sure the slabs are on the spawnable and not the translucent side. And light it up. Make sure there's no other mobs that can spawn. And then you dig these little holes out here so you can put in iron golems, because apparently iron golems and slimes have a beef with each other, and so slimes will try and go after the iron golem. Of course, iron golem doesn't like any mobs, so you just make this little hole here. Make sure it's too deep. I tried making it one deep and it trap the iron golem in the wall and it glitched die. So again, these little slabs, generally this time on the translucent side, makes it so they won't be mob spawnable. Create your little iron golem and boom, there he is, ready to attract slimes to the edge, and they will fall down and land on the... Look at that. The snow. That's gotta be a smiley face from the snow. Let's go check that out. That was completely unintentional. But yeah, so digging out this entire chunk after you find one that is a slime chunk takes quite a while. I went through 4 diamond picks, all with the mining beacon, all with efficiency 4, unbreaking 3. Hi, Mr. Spider. You're going down. Thank you, Mr. Spider. But yeah, and there's magna cube blocks at the bottom there. I catch the slime, burn them up. Hey, don't shoot at me. And you get the slime drops. But the snow, what an interesting way it melted. Totally unexpected. Let's see how it looks from up above here. This will also be our AFK platform once it's done. Oh, cool. Oh, I see what happened. That's neat. Well, that's a pleasant surprise. Little smiley face. Yay, smiley face. So, to get all this glass, we're going to need cactus, because we need green dye. And to get the green dye, we have to go find a desert to get enough cactus to create the dye. So we found this desert, and it looks like a decent desert. And there's some cactus, what we're here for. So let's go cactus hunting. I'll turn on the tunes.
Since I
little village was pretty good to sleep in over the night. Pretty sure they're not going to have anything we really want besides the cactus, so I'm just going to collect what cactus is here and go over and look at that desert temple here. We saw in the way, oh, what the? And, oh, good. There was a interesting lag moment. And, yeah. It's been a while since we've looked through a desert temple. I think out of all the weird temples around, desert temples tend to be my favorite. And they are also one of the first, if I remember correctly. The fact that they give you loot and TNT, it's always a nice one. Yeah, I've got pretty much two stacks of cactus. I don't think I'll need that many for our farm, but it's nice to have the extra so we can work right away on the dying of things. Alright, desert temple. I don't even know if I've gotten into one of these yet. Nope. Right on. Our first desert temple in our Let's Play series. Let's see, what did we get? What did we get loot-wise? Oh, that pick's good. Oh! Dang. There's water underneath. Huh. Okay. And in the boxes. Right on. Good apple. Some emeralds. That's pretty much nothing. Nothing. We'll take the gunpowder though. And I think we'll leave the rest. Yeah. What else we got here? More iron and gunpowder. Darn, I was hoping for a better setup. Time to get out. Alright, so we get back, and these two have somehow gotten loose again. Seems to happen quite often. Been keeping them close by. Guess it's even harder when they're all the way out into the treehouse. Let's see, where'd you go? Where are you, Gem? Gem? You disappear? Oh, there you are. That's a neat trick. How'd you do that one? Okay. Now you two just stay there. We're gonna go down and look at where we're gonna put this cactus farm. By the way, we love the beacon. The beacon has made it so much easier to mine around. I mean, we cleared out this whole area over here. So we can build our cactus farm. Along with other things over here. Our slime farm and... Yes, we like the beacon. We're going to have to get more beacons. Because the speed one is also nice to have. And I'm sure the other ones are as well. But so this is the basic cactus farm. There's sand. They grow up one block. Because there's a fence post there, they break. And then they fall down into a water collection system below. Small, compact, pretty easy to do. So let's get to building. Suits our purposes, and we cleaned it up a bit, made it look a little better, and this is what we got just waiting while we're working. The other thing we needed, and we did this all day long for very long periods of time, was collect green wool. We first tried to just breed them in captivity, but they're outpacing the growth of the grass. So then I just let them loose, and this seems to work. Considering that we had to make a 16 by 16 lime wool block, it required quite a few green sheep. There you can see the block over there as we're finishing it. And this is just what we'd do, run around. Went through 4 shears doing this. Probably should have put unbreaking on them. I never thought I'd have to put unbreaking on a shear. But yeah. All those sheep. Slime blockhead and our AFK platform inside. We just go in here and there's our smiley face and the slimes. We just sit here and watch the sunset. So until next time, thanks again.